So the experiment for today is antibiotic sensitivity test by paper disc method. There are two different methods. One is the tube dilution method. The other one is paper disc method. Paper disc method is easy, comfortable, and you get very good reliable results also. So the most preferable method to determine the antibiotic sensitivity test is the paper disc method. Okay. So for this experiment, what is the aim of this experiment? To determine the antibiotic sensitivity. To determine the antibiotic sensitivity or susceptibility pattern for a given test organism to various antimicrobial agents. So what is the theory behind this experiment? A variety of antibiotics are available for treatment of diseases. However, not all drugs are active against all infectious agents. Bacteria are susceptible to some drugs and not to the others. Also, some drugs may be more effective over the others. Hence, the physician needs to know the drug of choice for a particular treatment. In vitro testing is carried out to determine the drug of choice against an isolated pathogen to help the physician in the treatment. Usually, the order of preference of drugs is given to enable the physician. Are you able to see the screen?
No, ma'am.
Yeah, 1 minute. So usually the order of preference of drugs is given to enable the physician choose the optimum drug considering its availability, its properties and other factors. Kirby, Boyer's agar disc diffusion method is widely employed to determine the antibiotic susceptibility pattern of a pathogen. Now coming to the principle of this experiment, when different circular paper discs impregnated with a spectrum of antibiotics are placed on the agar plate, which is seeded with the test pathogen. The drug on each disc will diffuse into the immediate surroundings after incubation at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours. The long growth of the test culture will be interrupted by various zones of inhibition in the areas where the drug has diffused. No inhibition can be observed around the disc of a drug that has no effect against the pathogen. So the effectiveness of a drug is directly proportional to the diameter of the zone of inhibition produced. Again, I'm repeating, the effectiveness of a drug is directly proportional to the diameter of the zone of inhibition produced. Thus, the test provides a valuable information about the drugs that will not be of any use in the treatment or on those which can give us the maximum benefit. So in the case of the agar disc diffusion method, the test organism is inoculated onto the agar plate and antibiotic discs are placed on it while the cells are growing. The antibiotic drug diffuses from the disc and inhibits the growth around it. Depending on the size of inhibition zone, the sensitivity or resistance character of the test organism can be determined. Okay.
Vanita?
students?
Yes, ma'am.
It got stuck.
Yes, ma'am.
Net problem, ma'am. So these are the requirements. So generally we can use a nutrient agar media for the experiment, but also we have one more media which we can also use it, which is called as the Muller-Hilton agar media. So depending on the choice of your organism and the antimicrobial agent, you can use either the simple nutrient agar media or you can use the special media, which is the Muller-Hilton agar media. The composition will be completely different. Okay, then you can take the culture, so your study organism on which you want to test the susceptibility or resistant of the organism towards any antibiotic, you can choose the culture. Okay, then forceps, some sterile test tubes, and also the general other lab requirements. Then we will require the antibiotic discs. So now what we can do here is that antibiotic discs are also commercially available. So those discs will be already sterilized, and also it will be deposited with a particular concentration of the antibiotic on the disc. So when you're handling the disc, you have to be very careful. So that's a place where you'll be using these forceps. So with the help of the forceps, the antibiotic discs has to be used. So it is commercially available, the disc. I'll show it to you. And also, in case if we don't have an antibiotic disc, we have even a choice. What we can do is that antibiotic solutions are commercially available. So we can take that one and dilute it and get it to a particular concentration. And with the help of paper discs, which are sterile, you can dip it, dry it, and you can use that also as a disc. Okay, then cotton swabs, which is required for preparing the culture on the plate. So for that, we will require these cotton swabs. Okay, then procedure. What we do is that first, with a sterile wire loop, we have to pick up a 24-hour single old colony of a given culture, and we have to suspend it in 0.5 ml of the sterile saline in a test tube. So this is the first step. So take the organism, that is a test pathogen or the culture on which you want to determine or study the effect of the antibiotic. You have to prepare a 24-hour culture, and from that you pick up a colony and prepare it or put it into the sterile saline solution. After that, we have to dispense. You have to disperse the colony also, because you have taken colony as such from the culture media, from the solid media. It is not a liquid broth. So we have to disperse or dispense the colony by placing the sterile saline tube on a vertex mixture just for a minute. So the first step is done. Now coming to the next step, what we are doing is that you are going to take the sterile petri plate. The media has been sterilized and prepared. Once it comes to 45 degrees centigrade, we have to pour the culture media onto the sterile petri plate. After that, we have to label it. Choice of your antibiotics, what it is, you have to very clearly mark the antibiotics what you are using on the petri plate. So after labeling it, then we are going to do the next step. And you have to allow your culture media also to solidify. So once it has been solidified, that part is also now completed. Now we will immerse a sterile cotton or a wool swab into the cell suspension. Already we have created a cell suspension by taking a colony, inoculating it into the saline and putting it on the vertex mixture. We have got the cell suspension. So just with the sterile cotton, we have to immerse it and you have to take it. Now drain the excess suspension by pressing it against the wall of the tube. Now after this, the cotton swab has to be streaked all over the surface of the sterile agar plate in order to obtain a long growth of the pathogen. So first you have to prepare that one. After that, we have to place the plate inside the refrigerator for 10 minutes to allow the absorption of the culture onto the plate. Now, with the help of a sterile forceps, now place the different antibiotic discs at equal distance from each other. So that's why I told you, when you are using 3 or 4 antibiotics, let us lay the petri plate properly where we are going to place. And that place we will be keeping the disc. One more thing is that when these discs come out, our will be labeled as T. So we will see that one also. So that T, immediately with the forceps, you give a gentle press on the top of the disc so that it will attach to the surface of the agar. Okay. Now all these things has to be done only under sterile aseptic conditions. Once we have done it, now place a plate in a refrigerator for 1 hour to allow the diffusion of the drugs without cell propagation. So when you keep it at low temperature, the organisms which we have streaked with the help of a cotton swab will be quiescent for some time, whereas the drug which is present on the surface will start to diffuse to the media. So once 1 hour is over, then transfer the petri plate into the incubator, which has been already preset at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours in an inverted position. Okay. Now observation and results. So after 24 hours, we have to observe and check out the results. Now observe the clear zone of inhibition around the disc. Measure the diameter of all the zones as an express in millimeter against each. Write or conclude your experiment. What has happened? How much effective was your antimicrobial agent against your organism? You have to understand the zone of inhibition. So after measuring it, if the zone of inhibition is greater than 15 millimeter, then we can report that the organism which we have taken for our study is susceptible to that particular antibiotic or the antimicrobial agent. If the zone is in the range of 6 to 15 mm, then we can report that the organism or the test pathogen is intermediate sensitivity. If the zone of inhibition is less than 6 mm, then it should be reported that that particular strain or the organism which we have taken for our study is resistant towards that particular antibiotic. Then, so we can draw a small tabular column and we can write the list of all the antibiotics what we have kept, and we can measure using a scale the zone of inhibition and note it down. So based on this result, what I have told to you, and once experiment is over, we can measure it and then we can write whether the organism what we have taken for our study is susceptible or intermediate sensitive or it is resistant. Now conclusion, antibiotic susceptibility pattern was determined for the given pathogen. So that depends on the experiment what we are doing and we can tabulate it. Now there are a few important points which has to be noted down when we are doing this experiment. The first thing is that we should not keep the disc very close to the flame, because we are going to work it under the flame. So when you're working it, the disc which is having the antibiotic must be kept away from the flame, because which is having the drugs can get inactivated by the heat. And we have to work only in the laminar airflow chamber, and we have to use the sterilized inoculating lobe. So these are the basic principle, procedure, and how to observe once the experiment is over. Okay, so thank you students, and we will show you the experiment also how it has to be done.